Figure AI has revealed that its Figure 02 robot has received a major upgrade to its walking capabilities. It's now considerably more natural. On the Figure X Twitter page and its website, it does explain how, in summary, it was able to do this. But there are a lot of technical terms. For example, the main randomization in simulation with high-frequency talk feedback on the robot. So I dived in to decode the jargon. A year ago, a comment was left on a Figure robot video where the user wrote, "Walks like Joe Biden, but probably doesn't fall over so much." These words must have burdened Figure CEO Brad Adcock as he shared a screenshot of it and wrote in an X post, "Say goodbye to the Biden walk. He seems joyful about it." So let's look at what's changed. In this recent video update, we see Figure 02 walking naturally, and then a comparison of its walk before and after. In the before, we see Figure walking slowly, with its upper and lower legs bent more than normal. It gives the appearance of being frail and unsteady, so I can understand the Biden walk comparison. The VO2 update, you immediately see the difference between the two. Its legs are less bent, it's more up straight, it's standing higher, and it's walking faster. A noticeable improvement. How Figure 02's walking improved. This more natural human-like walking style was achieved by trial and error using a computer simulation, allowing the robot to quickly learn complex movements before testing them in the real world. How can years of training happen in hours? Normally, teaching a robot to walk like a human would take years of trial and error training in the real world. Instead, Figure AI uses a high-fidelity physics simulator. This is a virtual environment that accurately emulates real-world physics. This includes different terrain types and how a simulated robot walks and reacts to different terrains. In this simulation, by running thousands of training scenarios at super fast speeds, the AI can experience years worth of movement data in just a few hours. Think of it like a video game running in fast forward mode, where the robot's AI gets to practice the best way to walk thousands of times in a fraction of the time it would take in real life. It can make slight adjustments to its movements and learn from trial and error, over time getting much closer to human-like walking. What is the main randomization with high-frequency talk feedback? Main randomization means that during training, the AI is exposed to small random changes in the environment, such as different ground surfaces or slight shifts in its weight. This prevents it from getting too reliant on a perfectly predictable simulation and makes it more adaptable to real-world conditions. High-frequency talk feedback means the robot constantly measures the force applied to its joints and adjusts in real time, just how humans adjust their balance while walking. Together, these techniques make sure that AI's movements aren't just good in the simulation, but also work in real life and can react to new environments without extra tweaking. What is Figure's end-to-end neural network? Figure AI uses an end-to-end neural network, which means that the AI learns the entire walking process, from understanding balance to adjusting its steps without human engineers manually coding each movement. Instead, it learns through trial and error in the simulation using reinforcement learning. If the robot falls or walks awkwardly, it receives a negative score. If it walks well, it receives a positive score. Over time, it will learn how to walk efficiently. What is zero shot to real hardware and what is sim to real transfer? This means that after training in the simulation, the AI can immediately control the real-world robot without needing extra fine-tuning. Normally, an AI trained in a simulation needs to be adjusted when it's used on a real robot, because simulations are never perfect. However, Figure AI has designed its system so well that the robot can walk better in real life, straight after training in the sim. So zero shot means the simulated learnings don't need to be adjusted for the robot, and sim to real transfer means a learned skill can be successfully applied to a real-world robot, i.e. what's learned in the virtual world is learned by the real robot. And yes, this did make me think of The Matrix with Neo and how he learns Kung Fu. What is a high-fidelity physics simulator? A high-fidelity physics simulator is a super-accurate virtual environment that emulates real-world physics. It ensures that when the robot moves in the simulation, forces, gravity, and balance behave just like they would in real life. This prevents the AI from learning bad habits, such as moving in ways that wouldn't work in the real world. reaction to Figaro 2's natural walking upgrade. Reaction-wise, there's been generally a positive reception in the YouTube comments. User Tizetso Remigo says, comparing this to Figaro 1 you shared 12 months ago is beyond amazing. We know you, says, so close, almost perfect, good job. And a little more skeptical of the hype is user Lipe. He says, everybody gangster until the LED turns red. I thought that was quite funny. Figure AI has taken a major step towards making humanoid robots walk naturally by training in a high-speed simulation, using reinforcement learning, and applying smart sim to real techniques. The robot can instantly apply its learning in the real world. This means faster progress in robotics and more lifelike movements in humanoid robots in the future.